bring tonight your performer to the stage. This gentleman has opened for the likes of Tommy Davidson and J. Anthony Brown. Folks, this is his live DVD special, Underrated. I need you on your feet right now. Give it up for him, folks. It's Nate Williams. Left me for another woman?
told you, everything I say up here is the truth. Nothing but the truth. So help me God. This woman left me for another man. One, look at him over there talking about, did he really? Did she really leave? Yeah, she left. Came in there and told me she was in love with another woman. I said, well, bitch, we finna split this one in three ways. You finna move that bitch right on in here. Think you just finna get some pussy and leave? Hell no, we finna move that bitch in. But it was my bad though, cause I ignored all the signs and shit. I ignored everything. And you know, when a woman leave you for another woman, your black friends go ask you, you ain't know this shit. So you telling me you didn't see the shit coming? That's what you telling me? Then I started to think about it. I said, you know what? I ignored all the damn signs. I ignored everything. She cut the grass. Changed the oil in the truck. You out there changing the oil? Changed the oil in the truck. She beat me in Madden. How the fuck? Beat me in Madden, dog. Going Hail Marys all day. When I caught a pin standing up, that's when I really should have moved. I said, is you pin standing up? What the fuck is going on? That's what I said, ugh. Ugh, bitch. But anyway, that hoe left. I said, you know what, I'm tired. The hoe left. Was I mad? Yeah. Call it what you want. I was in my feelings for about 2 years. So I said, fuck it. I'm moving back in with my mom and my dad. Upside of it, I can save money. Downside, my stepdaddy, 81, my mama, 61. Y'all don't know where I'm going with this, but here it comes. But he still sling wood in the house. Call it what you want. My pain, everything I say is the truth. Nothing but the truth. So help me God. And my room was right next to there. Y'all finna feel this shit. My room was right next to theirs.
Don't do it.
And he used to wear our ass out. Head boy hitting against the wall, moaning and groaning, and she used to come over there like this. Are you all right? I'm like, hell no. Are you all right? He wearing your ass up. You all right? Y'all don't understand. Everything I say is the truth. Nothing but the truth. So help me God. But what was really fucked up was they had Viagra now. Some of y'all 55 and up know what I'm talking about. Hell yeah. I'm like, no, hell yeah. My stepdaddy used to sit back, get the sheets ready. Look at them silk sheets. You ain't gonna fuck my mama. Not tonight. Hell no. The bad part about it was living with them. They forgot I had a damn key. I come in the house 12 o'clock at night. He in there in a fucking pamper. giving you no ass tonight. You know when you're 81, you try to get all the pumps you can get. You know what I'm talking about? She was fighting this shit. Hey, hey, nigga, not tonight. I got a headache. I gotta go to Walmart. Fuck with all these workers ain't doing shit. And here you is, you wanna fuck? Now my ear on the wall. I'm like, hell yeah, mama, don't give him shit. But when you that old, you say some shit that just stick with you. And that's what my mama did. Cause she had some comeback lines. So my stepdaddy was like, I tell you what, next time you want, I ain't giving you shit. I ain't giving you the dick. My mama stood up and said some shit I'd never heard in my life. She said, nigga, fuck you and the Moses balls. Moses balls. Y'all gonna see somebody old trying to hit on you tomorrow. All you young ladies, y'all gonna say, get away from me with the Moses balls. Old man love to fuck. I know, cause I stay in the house. Everything I say is the truth. Nothing but the truth. So help me God. So now, I'm trying to get out the house. And I just can't do it. I can't. So now I'm trying to get out the house. I'm trying to date. Anybody here dating, like freshly dating? This is their first date in here tonight? Cause I'm trying to date, and dating hard as hell, ain't it? Ain't it hard to date? I'm trying to date through Facebook. I'm trying now, cause you don't know, every female mood is all fucked up. One day, I love God, I just got baptized, thank you Jesus. Monday, Tuesday, fuck everybody, fuck that nigga. Emotional bitch. So now I'm trying to date. So I found this lady and I took her to the best restaurant possible. I was on my way to a comedy show. 3 hours away. I took her to McDonald's. So y'all don't eat at McDonald's. Don't y'all trying to tell me? Who don't eat at McDonald's?
I don't.
Okay, I'm sorry. They ask you to apply for an application. Do you eat there? Nah, they got an attitude. Hell nah, I don't eat that fake ass. Bullshit. The frosting machine always fucked up. I go through there every night, try to get a McFlurry, and these bitches ain't got no ice cream. They don't never fix the shit. Got on blue jeans. That's what I'm trying to figure out. Nigga, name tag say Lil D. What the fuck is your real name? Who is Lil D? I pull up through the drive-thru, all the workers outside smoking weed. Taking my order from outside. Man, what the fuck you want, man? That chicken? We out of those. Mac double, we out of those. Well, dog, what the fuck you got? You know what, nigga? You got a motherfucking attitude. We got some fries, bitch. But give me some goddamn fries, then. Hungry as hell out here. Hey, McDonald's, man. Always a bitch in there got an attitude. Always. You can't never go through there and get no fresh shit. Then they get mad because you come back through and want some hot shit. Bitch, that's your job. Heat up them fries, ho. Give me some hot fries, Howard. Then they try to test you. That's going to be about 5-6 minutes if you want to wait. Bitch, I'm going to wait. I love McDonald's. I love the fuck out of McDonald's. Sometimes I tell people, hey, I'm on my way to McDonald's. Don't get that shit, fuck that. I love McDonald's. I hold that attitude. They just hiring anybody. That's the problem. They hiring anybody. Hoes in there pregnant, losing their mind. Bitch, if you don't get on with that minimum wage attitude and give me a goddamn fry. Anyway. Fuck McDonald's. So I took my girl to McDonald's, right? And I got a frosting. Or ice cream or whatever the case. Whatever the fuck. So we got the driving. Wind is whatever. When you fucked up, it's all the same. You want something cold, get it. So we driving, and I ain't know the motherfucker was lactose intolerant. Everything I say is the truth. Nothing but the truth. So help me God. So she done farted all the way to the show. I said, you know what? I locked the windows and farted all the way back. I said, if I gotta smell your shit, you gotta smell it. That's how relationships work. It's hard dating a black woman. It's hard. It's hard dating a black woman, I'm telling you. Anybody know it's hard dating a black woman? Men?
It's hard dating a black woman.
Hold on, Light Bright. I ain't even know. She's speaking up like she got a mic. It's hard dating a motherfucking man. Damn, you been hurt? She's speaking up. That's how I date a motherfucking man if you want to talk about some shit. Talk about that. Hard dating a black woman. I'm dating a woman now. I'm in the bed with her. She don't dream to meet you. You had a dream of me cheating? Watching me while I'm asleep. And you know how y'all do, y'all stare down. To know who the fuck you was at the mall with. I dreamed of this bitch in a red dress.
Red dress?
Oh, I don't even go to the mall. Yes, you do. Bitch worked for DHS. She drive a Malibu. She got expired tags. So what that's letting me know is the bitch ain't shit. I'm dating this hoe? You ain't dating her, you fucking a nigga. So who all graduated? Graduation! Graduation, anybody else? Anybody go to a graduation? Fuck it, god damn. Shit. Uneducated? I ain't saying shit. Well, give it up for me, baby. I got 2 degrees. Woo! Yeah, I went to the best college on the planet. Arkansas Baptist! Okay. You don't fuck up. I went to this damn school. For what? I don't know. For what? I don't fucking know. I'm at the school, they ain't even paying the teachers. They got attitude. Sign the roll, get your ass out. Bitch, we ain't gonna learn nothing. Until they pay me, you ain't learning shit. 4 years I had this goddamn problem. Never got my school money on time. And you know black people, we playing shit with that school money. $35,000, $3,500? Shit, let me see, rent gonna be paid off for 2 months. Get that shit out of the way, get that Brazilian that's coming in. Give me some new shoes, kick it, go out with my girls. And we going, that motherfucker ain't got no school money? Fuck everything up. I'm like, fuck that shit, I graduated with 2 degrees with 190 fucking hours. How the fuck you graduate with 190 hours? I told that joke in Missouri, a white woman said, you got your master's. I was like, bitch, no I don't. Not at school that don't have master's. Then I walk in there, I say, hey, I think I'm supposed to graduate. They was like, yeah, we forgot about you, but I tell you what, come right over here on this wall. Whatever you want your degree to be, you just pick it. Whatever I want my degree to be. I'm here for business. She was like, oh, okay, well, this is this right here. What kind of shit is this? Education system fucked up, man. Y'all know it is. Tell you, I was fucked up all the way through high school. Anybody here go to North Little Rock High? Anybody? North Little Rock in the building. I went to that motherfucker. I'm mad as hell to my mama still today. Cause she decided she wanted to put me in special ed. In the 11th grade. With the principal, they like, hey, we gotta put this dumb ass in a special ed. But we don't put him in there, he ain't gonna graduate. So my mom agreed to the shit. Now I'm in the office with her. She don't agree to the shit. So I go to the room, there's 4 motherfuckers in there, right? Everything I say is the truth. Nothing but the truth. So help me God. So I'm in this motherfucking class with 4 motherfuckers. One over there licking glue off the wall. One over there finger painting. One over there looking in the mirror playing peekaboo and shit. Who the fuck?
Peekaboo. Peekaboo.
I said, with yourself?
Peekaboo.
One girl hitting on me. She slow as hell. She in there, you want it?
I like, I gotta get out this girl. How the fuck this gonna happen, but I gotta get the fuck out of
here. I'm in that motherfucker for a year straight. On some bullshit. I get my report card, take it home. My mama opened up, I ain't got shit but smiling faces on. Guess I don't get a grade? Faces. And my mama don't post the shit on the refrigerator. All her friends coming in and shit. Look at my baby, ain't he so smart? All the way down the report card. Resource. The fucked up part was I was like, fuck it, I'm gonna start dating one of these motherfuckers. So I decided to date this girl named Shanika. Oh, Lord. Yeah, she was slow as hell. But it was benefits. We parked close at the mall. You pointing at her? Are you slow? one of my own. Girl, why you didn't say nothing? I'm in here talking about us and you in here with we all slow. It's okay. We gonna make it. But what I hated was award day. Award day was where they took everybody from every class and took our ass in the gym. So my teacher decided to take our slow ass class to the fucking gym. So the bad part about it was I had to guide these motherfuckers to the damn gym. So I'm in the motherfucker like this.
Get off of that because my feelings starting to get hurt. What a freaking lady is that?
Ain't about a freak. I'm talking about that real shit, man. I don't know why y'all have y'all just got baptized. Ain't gonna tell them that shit. Ain't gonna tell them all that. See, I'm dating a girl that's freaky as hell. But she be freaky at the wrong damn time. Anybody be freaky at the wrong time? They send you a text message out of the blue. So I'm in church. On my way to get baptized. I said, look, you need to get down here. Now she been holding out for 2 years, so we was holding on. I said, well, I might as well go on and get dipped. If I'm waiting, you know what I'm saying? I might as well go on and do it right. So she sent me a text message while I'm putting my robe on. And I hear my phone go off. You know how it go off. I go over there and check it. I said, hey, you need to come home right now. I'm going to put your balls in my mouth. I went up to the pastor, I said, hey. Today might not be the day. Can we schedule this another week? One time she tried to be freaking with me in Dollar General. We like to call it the mall. But if you want to get fancy, you call it Dole General. Sound nice, don't it? Yeah. Where you going? To the mall. I'm going to Dole General. So she decided that it was all right for her to put her finger in my butt. Without a glove on, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. No lube. Yeah, you're right. So I was bending over looking at the lotion. And all I heard was. Only thing I know is I blacked out. When I came to, I was in the security office. Because I had DDT'd the hell out of me. Because sometimes women play too much. Y'all play too much. Anybody playing kickball out there in the state? Anybody? I decided to go out there and play. So I kicked the ball. Coming around second, pulled my damn hamstring. Only thing I started to do was say, bitch, damn, bucket, fuck you, and fuck you. Because you know when niggas get hurt, don't nothing matter. Ah, fuck you, shit. But I forgot I don't volunteer on a church kickball team. Now this is a white church. He come and get me like, hey son, hey, calm down, it's alright. I'm like, man, fuck that. Get me to the sideline quick. Fuck this shit. So he's holding me, I'm standing like, fuck it. Fuck this shit. Pastor sent me down. He's like, man, calm down. He was like, let me stretch you out. I was like, man, fuck! Pastor said, you know what? Fuck this shit. I ain't gonna do this. Yeah, Pastor cussed me out. I'm trying to find a church home too. Anybody go to church? Anybody here? You cannot be in a group of black people and say you do not have a church home. It's not gonna go smooth. Not at all. Especially if you got five different church members that go to different churches. gonna be like an auction in that motherfucker. You ought to come to St. Luke. You ought to come to First Baptist. Second Baptist. Look at them. Look at all these church people. Claiming it now. So I decided I found a church called New Saint Believers on Christ, the Solid Rock. I stand washed in the blood of the Lamb, and then the name of the Missionary Baptist Church. But a great honorable Reverend, do no wrong. And you gotta say that before you join. Because I know a lot of y'all think I'm bullshit, but it's called New Saint Believers on Christ, the Solid Rock. I stand washed in the blood of the Lamb, redeemed and made whole, and never broken Missionary Baptist Church. Well, we don't give 10%, but 20%. So that you may receive. Yes, Lord, yes. The great honorable Reverend, do no wrong. And man, y'all gotta start protecting these ladies, man. Start protecting these ladies. Stop hitting on them. Yeah. Stop choking them. Y'all know people in abusive relationships?
Yeah.
Don't you? Y'all know it right now. In abusive relationships. I was in church's chicken. And a dude started disrespecting this girl. And I said, you know what? I'm not dealing with this shit. He was like, fuck you, bitch. I want a three-piece. I said what I want. Get it. She was like, well, I don't have enough. How many? He was like, bitch, it ain't about you. It's about me, bitch. And I want three pieces of chicken. So you need to get my chicken or I'm whooping your ass. I said, if he cuss her out one more time, I'm getting up. Because I can't deal with this shit. So I bit down on a chicken strip. Waiting on some shit to pop up. But I said, if he hauled back and swing, I'ma let that nigga have it. I grabbed my asthma pump. You don't know when shit gonna pop off. And I can't breathe. You know what I'm talking about? Grab my asthma pump. Said, you know what? Fuck this shit. I stood up. That nigga said one more thing to her. He said, you know what, bitch? If I don't get a three-piece, I'ma shoot you in the fucking face. I said, you know what? Chicken ain't that motherfucker. You mad about chicken? Chicken. Everything I say is the truth. Nothing but the truth. So.
Oh my God.
Y'all a little late. This is on DVD and y'all slow. You was in my class and I didn't even know. We're gonna try it one more time. As a group. Everything I say is the truth. Nothing but the truth. So.
Amen.
Sound perfect. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And you drink. Hallelujah. Amen. What are women that love to get hit? Don't be perfect now. That's what I know. Some women ain't get paid. I don't like it. The women always try to prove me wrong. And they love to brag about their head then. You ain't had no head till you had my head. Shut the fuck up. So a lady gave me some head one time. I faked it. I was like, oh, the head is wonderful. Where you get that mouth from? Nasty old bowl on the phone and shit. Girl, he can last 30 seconds with this head. Shut the fuck up. I was faking. Everything I say is the truth, nothing but the truth. Sounds perfect. That's pretty much my time. So, I'm gonna give y'all some brief history. I am the first fucking comedian local to sell this bitch out. Has been made in a fucking loony bin. Yeah. It took a black man to do it. By far, I ain't racist at all. I got a gang of good white friends. Gang of them. Right. But we gotta speak truth.
All right.
Sound like a passing on. But we gotta speak the truth. Sold this bitch out in 3 days. One for the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Many have came before me and couldn't do what I've done. Yes. Many have came. Y'all didn't know this is a testimony. I said, these people don't want to go to hell. Cut the air off. Let's test them. I see your fans out there waving. You're hot. You don't want to go to hell. No, you don't. Me and my crew have traveled near and far telling jokes. One time the devil tried to take me out. I was in Wichita, Kansas, cracking jokes. And a guy told me, if you say one more thing to me, I'm going to the trunk. I said, you know what? Maybe comedy isn't for me. But the devil tried to knock me off my course. So I came back home to do this live DVD taping. You're a part of history here. Yes. How many people you know sell tickets and come to your home? With 1, 2, 3, sometimes 4 or 5 tickets. Ticketmaster ain't got shit on Nate motherfucking Willis. Ticketmaster ain't got shit on Nate motherfucking Willis. Delivering tickets while my car was on E. Just to get you in the building. But see, that's where it comes from. That's your passion. That's your love. Yes. This is my heart. Yes. Pouring it out here on stage tonight on a Sunday. Yep. You could have been anywhere. Yeah. You could have been anywhere. But you chose to be here tonight. Yeah. 6:30, doors open. 7:30, showtime. And we started on time. Ain't got shit on Nate motherfucking Willis. Many of you I don't, but today is a new day. You know me now. I told you my story. My wife left me, true, for another woman. Bullshit. Live with my mom and dad, true! They fuck like jackrabbits. trying to get out of the house, trying to live better. True. So when you leave here tonight, hallelujah. I don't care if you're drinking, God turned water into wine. I'm not here to judge you. Do what you do. If you love pussy, goddamn it, love it. If you're gay, love it. But let me tell you something. When you leave here tonight, your Facebook status is better blow up. I went to see Nate motherfucking Willie at the motherfucking Loony Bean. And the motherfucker was sold out. People don't even know how much love and passion I put into this show. People don't know. I've been here for years working on this material, getting to this point. Me and Tyler, we sat down. Every time I got off stage, he gave me good advice. That's my friend. He don't even know. Love him like a brother. And he don't even know. But next, coming up for me, only God knows. Next, I'm shooting for New York City on May 28th. Woo! Opening up for a comedian from Comedy Central. This is my chance. One of many. Some of your inboxes have been so inspirational. Nate, do it. Let me know what you need. I ain't never had that type of love or passion for something that I love to do. 200 plus in a motherfucking building? What? Hello. But it only gets better. Kevin Hart, when he did his DVD special, sold out. Back at his home club. This is my home club and I sold out. Following in footsteps of legends. I also want to give a shout out to a good friend I met yesterday. He's a legend in comedy. He's been on Parenthood, Martin First Amendment. I met him yesterday. We sat down and talked for almost an hour about comedy. Said, hey, you go to New York, I can get you 7 shows in 2 days. You'll make over $1,000. And he's in this building tonight. He came to check me out. Just to open up. 10 minutes is all I need. People will throw you off your track, try to throw you off of it. Get in your head, tell you shit that don't make no sense. But this is my life. This is comedy. Comedy is the only thing that brings us closer together. So when you leave here tonight, let the world know about Nate Williams. I'm a representation of Arkansas. Yeah. Nate motherfucking Williams. I need to know, did you have a good time?
Yeah.
Well, stand on your feet, because I need to know, did you have a good time? It only gets better for me. I thank you. I love you. Appreciate it.
It was great, Nate, and everybody that opened for him was awesome.
Did y'all enjoy the show?
Yeah.
I'm Peanut's
baby. Oh, you got to hold it, not
tap. These are all of his cousins.
Who was Peanut?
Nate. My brother Williams.
Y'all enjoy Nate Williams?
Yes. Man, you shout out, bro, to Nate Williams, man. You keep doing your thing, man. Don't let nobody stop you, man. Don't let nobody deteriorate your dream, brother. God bless you, man. We love you, bro. We behind you 100%, bro.
Make sure you say